3, 2, 1, 0.
We thank Thee each morning for a newborn day, where we may work the fields of new-mown hay. We thank Thee for the sunshine and the air that we breathe, O Lord. We thank Thee. Thank Thee for the rivers that run all day. Thank Thee for the little birds that sing along the way. Thank Thee for the trees and the deep blue sea, O Lord. We thank Thee. Oh yes, we thank Thee, Lord, for every flower that blooms, birds that sing, fish that swim, and the light of the moon. We thank Thee every day as we kneel and pray, that we were born with eyes to see these things. Thank Thee for the fields where the clover is grown. Thank Thee for the pastures where cattle may roam. Thank Thee for Thy love so pure and free. Every flower that blooms, birds that sing, fish that swim, and the light of the moon. We thank Thee every day as we kneel and pray, that we were born with eyes to see these things. Yes, we thank Thee for the fields where the clover is grown. Thank Thee for the pastures where cattle may roam. Thank Thee for Thy love so pure and so free, O Lord. We thank Thee.
Jesus, Lord, we are indeed looking up unto you in this confusing moment. And for we have no option than to give thanks according to your word that says in everything we should give thanks. We are nowhere to query or to question your decision. For we are mortal body. You are the immortal, the Lord that is above all. So on this note, at this gathering, we say thank you. Because you are still God, we say thank you. For you are in charge, it doesn't matter what we are going through, you are a faithful God. So Lord, at this gathering this evening, we return thanks unto you because you gave to us your son, Baba Tunde Adewale. You gave him the privilege of education, privilege of getting married, privilege of blessing the marriage with his wonderful children. The word says there is time for everything. Lord, we are looking up unto you at this confusing moment that you speak peace to the heart of the wife. Speak peace to the heart of the children. Comfort them on every side. Never allow them to be a no. Life will not be punctured. Lord, we pray for Mama Adewale. The Lord will uphold you. The Lord will speak peace to your turbulent heart. The Lord will show himself as a mighty man in battle in every area of your needs in the name of Jesus. Amen. For your children, they will not be wayward. Amen. Their tomorrow will not be tampered. Amen. They are going to make it in life. Amen. And the Lord will catapult them to the greater height. Amen. After this thick dark cloud, joy will visit your family. Amen. Your tomorrow is guaranteed. Amen. Lord, we ask that your Holy Spirit will lead us in this service of songs. That the name of the Lord be glorified. Amen. Speak peace to Papa's society. Speak peace to Mama's society. Speak peace to the heart of the family members. That at the end of this day, our lives, we begin to receive inspiration from above that it can be any time for any one of us. So that we'll be able to see you before we see death. Thank you, Heavenly Father.
Thank you.
Blessed be your holy name.
Amen.
Through Christ our Lord and our Savior.
Amen.
The Lord's Prayer together.
Amen.
My Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. That we may not forget as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever and ever. Amen.
Out of the deep have I called unto thee, O Lord. Lord, hear my voice.
Lord, I hear, consider well the voice of my complaint.
If thou, Lord, will be a strength to mark what is done amiss, O Lord, who we abide it. I look for the Lord, my soul doth wait for him, in his word is my trust.
My soul.
O Israel, trust in the Lord, for with the Lord there is mercy, and with him is plenteous redemption.
And he shall redeem Israel from all his sins.
Thank you. today's Bible reading is taken from the book of Ecclesiastes, chapter 3, verse 1 to 15. And I read, "Everything that happens in this world happens at the time God chooses. He sets the time for birth and the time for death, the time for planting and the time for pulling up, the time for killing and the time for healing, the time for tearing down and the time for building. He sets the time for sorrow and the time for joy, the time for mourning and the time for dancing, the time for making love and the time for not making love, the time for kissing and the time for not kissing. He sets the time for finding and the time for losing, the time for saving and the time for throwing away, the time for tearing and the time for mending, the time for silence and the time for talk. He sets the time for love and the time for hate, the time for war and the time for peace. What do we gain from all our work? I know the heavy burdens that God has laid on us. He has set the right time for everything. He has given us a desire to know the future, but never gives us the satisfaction of fully understanding what he does. So I realized that all we can do is be happy and do the best we can while we are still alive. All of us should eat and drink and enjoy what we have worked for. It is God's gift. I know that everything God does will last forever. You can't add anything to it or take anything away from it. And one thing God does is to make us stand in awe of him. Whatever happens or can happen has already happened before. God makes the same thing happen again and again. This is the word of God.
Thanks be to God. Hymn number 51, page 21.
Thank you.
no guilt in life, no fear in death. This is the power of Christ in me. From life's first cry to final breath, Jesus commands my destiny. No power of air, no scheme of man can ever pluck me from his end till he returns or calls me home. Here in the power of Christ, I stand. In Christ alone, my hope is found. Please rise as we take this in. Please be seated.
The Bible reading is taken from the book of Romans 8, 31 to 39. And I read, "What shall we then say to these things? If God be for us, who can be against us? He that spared not his own son, but delivered him up for us all, how shall he not with him also freely give us all things? Who shall lay anything to the charge of God's elect? It is God that justifieth. Who is he that condemneth? It is Christ that died, yea, rather, that is risen again. Who is even at the right hand of God? Who also maketh intercession for us? Who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall tribulation, or distress, or persecution, or famine, or nakedness, or peril, or sword? As it is written, for thy sake we killed all the day long. We are accounted as sheep for the slaughter. Nay, in all these things we are more than conquerors through him that loved us. For I am persuaded that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor any other creature shall be able to separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus our Lord." This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Hymn number 28, page 13. We rise as we take the hymn. Hymn 28, page 13. Thank you.
The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Let us kneel. We want to pray for the children, the entire family, and the community. Our loving and kind Father, who created us in his image and his likeness, who numbered our days, who gave us everything in Christ Jesus. We adore your name and magnify you for the life of your son, our father, late Mr. Moses Babatunde Adewale. We thank you for the life well spent. We thank you for all the privileges he enjoyed through your grace while he walked through this path of eternity before he finally laid down his sword at your feet. Lord, be magnified in the name of Jesus Christ. Lord, at a time like this, we pray for the children. You are the father of the fatherless. And from book Genesis to Revelation, we have and we read of your majestic power and splendor on how you came through for the fatherless. Lord, we pray for this one, that you yourself will be their father in the name of Jesus Christ. Father means source. I pray for you, children, that the Lord God Almighty himself will be your source of everything you need in life to succeed in the name of Jesus Christ. His promise in Joshua chapter 1 verse 3 is that wherever you tread upon, that I have taken for you. And he did this in the life of Joseph. He was a stranger in Egypt. He did it for Daniel. He was a stranger in Babylon. He did it for Esther. I pray that the God of these patriarchs and matriarchs of faith we go with you as you continue the journey of life in the name of Jesus Christ. Mommy, I pray for you. Mark chapter 4, verse 39. The Bible says, and he arose and he spoke to the winds and he said, peace be still. And there was peace. I pray for you that at a time like this, the peace of God, which surpasses human understanding, will rule your heart in the name of Jesus Christ. When a man consoles, we can still cry. But when God himself consoles, we won't cry again. Because one of the responsibilities of the Holy Spirit is to come and comfort us. I pray that the Holy Spirit in you will comfort you in the name of Jesus Christ. This event will not break you down, but it will make you stronger in the name of Jesus Christ. We pray for the community, O Heavenly Father, that Papa lived in. We pray that as they mourn as well, you will console them in the name of Jesus Christ. We pray that the space left by him, the space created by him, you will fill up in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. You will continue to increase the community in leaps and bounds in the name of Jesus Christ. We pray that quick succession of death will not be their portion in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. And all of us together, we pray that as we mourn at a time like this, we will all come out stronger and better. And when our own time will come also, that we shall lay down our sword and meet you in the sky at the sound of the trump of the angel. Lord, we pray that grace to hold forth till that period, please give unto us in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Heavenly Father. In the name of Jesus Christ, we have prayed.
And so, our Father and our God, we bless you, we worship your name, we thank you for Church of God. We pray at a time like this that the church of the Lord will work strong and strong in the mighty name of Jesus. In the face of every tribulations, calamities ahead, make your church strong in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, we pray for the society that Baba belongs to, Christian friends with his family. Lord, ma fi shakufa laarin won loruko Jesus. Lord, ojo odun ko jina sira won loruko Jesus. Lord, we pray that that love that bound all the societies together, may he work strong and strong in the name of Jesus. We pray for every member that will miss. Father, by the power in the name of Jesus, support them when they need in the name of Jesus. The vacuum that Baba has left, Father, we decree by the power in the name of Jesus. Lord, support them in the name of Jesus. We pray for the community at large, strengthen us. Lord, as we mourn, Father, we decree, put laughter in our eyes once again in the mighty name of Jesus. We pray, Lord, that you, Lord God, will make this a better way for all of us in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, we decree as we sojourn on this earth, Father, strengthen us. Lord, we ask that you will support us. Lord, make all of us make heaven in the mighty name of Jesus. As we go through our lives on earth, give us grace to enjoy life and grant us success to meet with you in the mighty name of Jesus. Depart from me shall not be our portion in the name of Jesus. We soak everyone with the blood of Jesus. We decree for church and the society, Lord, you shall be their sufficiency in the name of Jesus. Support them in time of need. These and many more we ask through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Thank you. Now we want to listen to a few testimonies about the deeds of Daddy when he was with us on this side of eternity. And so we are going to take the format, just three persons, one among the children, one from the community where Papa lived, and of course for the church, Christian friends would take that and they will give their anthem if they want to. They give the tribute and they will still render their anthem. So from the children, someone from the children, please, let's clap for Jesus.
My name is Moshokwe Foluwa Adewale. I am the daughter of Mr. Moses Babatunde Adewale. Firstly, I would like to thank everybody who is present here and everyone who joined us on Zoom and YouTube. Thank you for honoring us. We, the family, appreciate you so much, and we pray that as you have honored us, God would also honor you. I really don't know where to start from. My dad was the most amazing man you could ever think of. I'm sorry. He was the most amazing father you could ever think of. I know everybody says their father is the best, but mine was, at least, he was the best to me. He was an intentional father to his children, to his nieces and nephew. He was a father figure to all. My dad was always ready to help everybody and anybody as long as they came from myself, my brother, or any one of the family members. Even though he was busy, he was always present at anything we were doing, whether it was a recital, a prize giving, if we were graduating from school, even if he was on a flight, Daddy will make sure that he gets there before any of the events finished. He's always been my role model. He's such a hardworking man, and he's always giving us the strength to persevere, to push on, to be the best we could be. Without him, none of us would be as great as we are today, and we are so grateful to him, and we're so thankful that even if he wasn't born with the type of opportunities we were, or into the type of family we were born into, he struggled so much so that he could give his children and other people the opportunities he never had. He was a kind man. My dad was so kind. He was always ready to help everybody, whether he knew you or not. As long as he was in the position to help, he always wanted to help. He was generous, he was caring, he was loving to his wife, to his children, to all his family members and friends. And at least the crowd we can see here can testify to that, that he really impacted everybody's lives, from his place of work, to church, to his community of friends. I'm so grateful that I have been blessed with such a father. It's not easy to let him go, but God knows better than we do, and we're just going to accept that it is the will of God. But
let's clap for Jesus.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, thank you, thank you. The Lord will always be your father.
Amen.
And none of you will suffer setback.
Amen.
Your tomorrow will never be punctured.
Amen.
Joy will locate you.
Amen.
A round of applause to Jesus. God bless you. God bless you.
Thank you very much.
God bless you. Now from the community where Daddy lived, someone from Kumada here in Lagos or in Ibadan.
Praise ye the Lord. I'm taking the definition of someone who lives in this neighborhood very loosely, because I would not want to miss the chance to give this tribute. My first interaction with Mr. Adewale was about 20 years ago. Right in the church. It was adult harvest time. And sections had been allotted to societies. My wife and I, not being members of any society in the church, when we got to church, and the pews were filled, even the two pews that were allotted to members of the Dean Society, as we went from section to section, we were treated like lepers. So it was Mr. Adewale. I didn't know him from Adam then. He just looked at us because we were flummoxed. In fact, I was telling my wife, I said, I think we need to leave. So Mr. Adewale just beckoned, and he got up, and he said, please, I don't remember who was sitting next to him, but he had to plead with that person to allow us. That was about 20 years ago. Thereafter, we forged a friendship. We used to exchange WhatsApp messages until the last election, when we went different ways as far as candidates were concerned. As a matter of fact, I was telling my wife last week or the week before that I had not seen Mr. Adewale for some time. And I put a call through to his first number. It was switched off. The second number, somebody who I think must be that young man there, answered the call, and I said, may I speak with Mr. Adewale, please? He said, no, he's not around. I said, when can I call him back? He said, he's not around. And he spoke to me gruffly that I realized that he did not want me to pursue that line any longer. So I gave up. And I told my wife, I said, I called Mr. Adewale, but it was his son that picked the call. And he just told me that he was not around. So to my shock, my wife came home yesterday because I was not in church. And just said, do you know Mr. Adewale passed? And I was shocked. To my marrow, I was shocked. He was such a kind gentleman. He was genial, personable. He was debonair, as we can all see there. I always joke with my wife that he looks like a minister. So I will miss him because one or two times we've met up in Abuja and we've interacted. And just like I said, we used to exchange WhatsApp messages, particularly on the politics of Nigeria, until I realized that we were diametrically opposed. So my prayer is that the good Lord will rest his soul and he will grant the peace and comfort that only he can afford to the family he's leaving behind.
Amen.
I thank you for your attention.
A round of applause for Jesus. Now, Christian friends.
Our Father in the Lord, the canon residentiary, the clergy here present, members of the Christian Friends Society, all other societies here present this evening, all the sweet ladies and gentlemen, I'm here to give a testimony on behalf of Christian Friends Society of the Archbishop Vining Memorial Church Cathedral. Our dear Mrs. Helen Adewale and the children, the Christian Friends Society commiserates with the entire family. I think the canon residentiary said it all when he said it's a time of confusion, a time of dark cloud. We can feel your grief. We can feel your pain. However, as Christians, we should have it and know that the Lord giveth. It is the Lord that gives. And it is indeed the Almighty God that also taketh. Those are the two ends to it. As Christians, it is clear to each and every one of us that it is not how long we stay in this world, in our sojourn on earth. It is how well. It is the souls that we touch, and indeed the positive impact, like the daughter said, the positive impact that we, you know, impact the society and people as a whole. Our dear brother created impact in various platforms. On the Christian Friends ground, he was a quiet, amiable, easygoing person, and indeed very strategic in his thoughts. Once a while, he called me, Shiji, what are you thinking about this? What are your plans on this? Have you thought about A and B and C? He was soft-spoken, but yet very strategic. Within the church, our dear brother Tunde Adewale worshiped God in his own faithfulness. And he was a bit quiet, but then he comes to service regularly and he worships quietly. He's not actually like one of the noisemakers in the church, if I say that, you know. But he worships and then, you know, pray quietly. Amongst his friends, very selective in choosing friends. but he bonded very well with the friends that he chose. And in his field of endeavor, in the maritime industry, he excelled. Brother Adewale excelled very well. He attended so many courses, international courses, conferences, etc. And one thing he did in NIMASA, that's the Nigerian Maritime Administration and Safety Agency, NIMASA, he ensured that he aligned Nigeria with the global maritime standards. Please give him a round of applause. Not many people can do that. The clergy, the laity. The irony of life these days is that it is the good people that are dying. The bad eggs. It's either I say they refuse to die or they don't die easily. No, it's sad, you know. To meet someone like Brother Tunde Adewale, that's the honest truth. In fact, if you go towards the political front, make one or two sentences there. You have people, they ruled us some decades, they come back and rule us again, and then they unleash further tension and pressure on people. They don't die easily. That's the truth. You know, it's sad. It's really, really sad, but that's the truth. To the family, we commiserate with you. Our dear sister Helen, God is your strength. And God will be with you. We'll be with the entire family. God will give each and every one of us, as the family in particular, the fortitude to bear this irreplaceable loss. Praise the Lord. Praise the Heavenly Father. Thank you.
A round of applause for Jesus. Those are the youngest choristers in the house today. Please celebrate them, celebrate them, celebrate them. God bless you, sirs. Answer ile bukuni. Ile didon ati le wa. Nigba gbogbo lanso to go re. Yo ti dun to lati debe. We sing it in Yoruba fashion. Are we weak and heavy laden? Come back with a load of care. Precious Savior, still our refuge. Take it to the Lord in prayer. Do your friends despise, forsake you? Take it to the Lord in prayer. In his arms, He will take and shield you. You will find a solace there. What a friend we have in Jesus. Hymn number 37, page 16. We all rise as we take this in.
Gospel is written, and the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ as recorded by St. John chapter 14, beginning at the first verse. Let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I wouldn't have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. If I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself. And where I am, there ye may be also. And whither I go, ye know, and the way ye know. Thomas said unto him, Lord, we know not whither thou goest, and how can we know the way? Jesus said unto him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. This is the gospel of Christ.
Please sit. We return thanks and praises to God for counting us worthy to be among the living. We give him all glory. And I bring condolences from the Lord Bishop, the Right Reverend Dr. James Olushola Oredeji, and the Dean of the Cathedral, the good people of Cathedral, to you, our beloved sister, mother, and the wife of the faithful departed, Mrs. Eileen Adewale, and to the children, the grandchild, the daughter-in-law, and the entire Adewale family of Ibadan. Baba sends his prayer that the good Lord will comfort you all, will sustain you, and will hold each and every one of you by hand and lead you into the future that you might see, that you might think is confusing now. Praise the Lord. He's leading you on, and he will take care of you all in the mighty name of Jesus. Let us bow our heads for prayer. O death, where is thy sting? O grave, where is thy victory? The sting of death is sin, but thanks be to God, which giveth us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. And through him we have this love, with assurance that nothing, not even death, can separate us from his love for us. And so, Father, we thank you for the time and space so granted unto your Son, 60 years plus. We are grateful for that which you have done through him, in him, with him, and for him. May your name be praised forever in the mighty name of Jesus. You have called him back to your side. We pray, O Lord, that the family left behind, by your presence, you will make up for the absence of their father in the mighty name of Jesus. In our gathering this evening, Lord God, we want to hear you again and again. Speak to us. Let your word heal our wounds. Let your word open our eyes to the essence of life. Let your word open our eyes to that which lies above, not to that which is in the grave. Let your eyes open our, let your power, presence, open our eyes this evening to see you and see eternity ahead of us. In the name of God the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Praise the Lord. Much has been said about the faithful departed. God has his own record. We believe the record of God concerning him is of good. And so, for you, our mommy, because of what we all could see today, this evening, that you are, let me say, a bit down with what has happened. But let me tell you, it's happening all over the world every day. You are not the first, and you are not going to be the last. And of course, the journey ahead of you, God knows quite all right that 2023 you will become a widow. He knows. And I can assure you, he has made provision for that journey. Anna was a widow for 45 years. Praise the Lord. Especially when we are talking about someone like you, a woman of many parts in this cathedral. But for that 45 years, Hannah was standing firm. She was not discouraged. She could look at God every moment and smile, knowing fully well that God is much more, far, far better than her husband. Praise the Lord. There's to this extent that one could cry as a Christian. Praise the Lord, though. You can ask yourself, if I'm doing this much because of my husband, what have I been doing so much about Jesus? As my tears fill a bucket for Jesus, the situation we see, honestly, change what I put down to share with us. Oro Oluwa ni olori isiku. Oro Oluwa is the mourner and is the comforter. And I'll quickly give you these few words. They can copy it for you to serve as comfort and assurance that God is with you. Jeremiah 49. I know we don't have a Bible. I will read it from here. Jeremiah 49. And I read verse 11. Leave thy fatherless children to me. I will preserve them alive. And let thy widows trust in me. Praise the Lord. Another one before I go to the business of the day is Psalm 68. You must take it from here and accept it. Psalm 68 verse 5. I am a father to the fatherless and a judge of the widows. Praise the Lord. Psalm 146. I'll read just a verse there. The B part. He relieveth the fatherless and the widow. He will relieve you of all these pains. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. So, mommy and the children, be comforted. And let me tell you, you must see goodness in the death of your husband and the father of this family. What can be more? What could one ask from God? You were all together. Praise the Lord. Are you in Canada? Came home. Praise the Lord. The grandchild was around. Praise the Lord. And to that which I know, you all gave him the best of care, love. At the tail end of his life. You owe him nothing. He owed you nothing. And so you can be assured that he has a place with the Lord. That should be your joy. I said that should be your joy. And God will bless your family. In the mighty name of Jesus. For our meditation, one thing I have no fear of is death. Oh, that's me. Today, tomorrow, anytime. At any age. Praise the Lord. I have no fear of death. I'm ever conscious of it. I'm ready for it. And that takes me to the test. The test is Ecclesiastes chapter 9, the A part, chapter 9, verse 5, A part of verse 5. For the living know that they shall die. Can we say it together? I don't know. Are you afraid of that statement? Everyone that is living, I'm not talking of those that are just existing. If you are living, that means truly you have Christ. Christ has you. You will know. Because it's in the order of the life of Jesus Christ himself. Did Jesus Christ die or not? Huh? Every living. The living except for the fools. You know, Jeremiah, Psalm 14 verse 1 says, fool says in his heart, there is no God. But the Bible puts it, the Yoruba Bible puts it more succinctly. Say, as she will raise, shekini, o wini okore, wikbe, o lorun ko shekini, ko si. Belly to sorry, baby, as she were in co or jaw on Jekini. On Jekini. On co or jaw. As she were the fool, their mouths, they keep gathering, gathering. And when you look at the real mad people, when I was growing up, everyone man bonio, praise the Lord. Everyone man Jekini. They want to grab everything. A mad man, real man that is psycho, that you see him outside, naked, but you see him grabbing everything on his way or on our way. Boje agolo ni o, boje paper ni o, boje anything. Praise the Lord. So we quickly talk about death. Who has taken our beloved brother, father, husband away? Death is the most obedient servant of God. More obedient than any one of us. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. When Baba Ijogun was talking about young or old, one thing about death is he's blind. He's what? He's what? He doesn't know if this one is 1 year old or this one is 105 year old. Praise the Lord. He's deaf. He's dumb. He has no feeling. He has no emotion. Once it's assigned, he goes there. Death is escape from death and escape to eternal life for the faithful. Praise the Lord. This young boy that just died, Mobad, did a song. I never knew about him, but I heard that song. He said, when the pain will be over. Praise the Lord. The pain is over for Baba Adewale. Praise the Lord. That is confirmation that God owns you. Tell your neighbor, God owns you. Tell him he has the final say concerning you. Tell him or her, he is totally and firmly in charge of your life. So he calls anytime. He has the master plan of your life. Anytime, any day. I son kolong pa yon, praise the Lord. Accident kolong pa yon. That's why some people can be on sick bed. He will come and take him away. Some people can be, you see him strong. I saw him yesterday and he's active. We must take to heart every day that we must surely die and that we are a day's march near home. Our father in the Lord was preaching in this place sometimes last week. and said, who is next? Or is it Baba Sial? As many as we are, somebody is next. Praise the Lord. At least by, it could be 10 years or 100 years. But somebody is what? But since we do not know, we must take it upon ourselves to be conscious. Maybe we sing that song. The Lord is, can you help me? Our God is blessing someone today. Today. The Lord is blessed one today. The Lord will bless someone today. What happened? It could be you. It could be me. By my side. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Ojo ajina sira. Odun ajina sira. And that's what 2 Corinthians 5:10. Each and every one of us must appear and like the Pharaoh and to render everything that we have done, good or bad. Therefore, we must consider the following. I'll just run them through. You know them. Number one, you must believe in Jesus Christ. Tell your neighbor, you must believe in Jesus Christ. The Bible says, John 3:16, for God so what? Loved the world. That whosoever, whosoever, it's not to do with how many times you go to church, how many tithes you pay, or whatever. You believe in him, and you believe all about him. You believe in all his statements, and you believe carrying out all his statements. Praise the Lord. Number two, you must do good work. You must do what? You must do what? The work of your hand is not enough to save you, but it is enough to destroy you. And that is what we have in Matthew chapter 7. Matthew chapter 7. And I'll just take from verse 21. Matthew 7:21. Praise the Lord. Sorry, this is a new Bible, so I'm finding it difficult to open. Matthew 7:21. And I read to your hearing. Not everyone that said unto me, Lord, Lord, shall enter what? Into the kingdom of heaven. But he that doeth the will of my Father, which is in heaven. 22. Many will say to me in that day, Lord, have we not prophesied in thy name? In thy name have cast out devils, and in thy name done many wonderful things. 23. And then I, Jesus, will prophesy unto them, I never knew you. Depart from me, ye that walk iniquity. Do good work. Make a difference everywhere. Say, let your light so shine. And be salt. Salt to preserve, not to destroy. And of course, part of the good work is to impact the life of others. Value, add value to life of others. Another point is, you must utilize your treasure, your time, your talent. Praise the Lord. There's a research, I read it. The money of individual in banks are enough to take care of that nation. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Utilize your treasure, your time, your talent for others, for yourself, and for God. And that point is, you must hold on to the name of Jesus and hold on tight to salvation he has offered. Now you look at Acts of Apostles chapter 4 verse 12. It says, there is no name under which a man can be saved except the name of who? Check yourself as I check myself. Which name are you holding on to? Is it money, power, position, possession, juju, or which, the one they call jazz, or ritual, or court? Brethren, one thing is sure, and that is what is in Revelation 15, 11 to 15. He said there will be books and book. And I keep saying it, that the greatest tragedy of life is one not to be sincere with himself or herself. As you are seated, as I'm standing, I know if my name is in that book of life or not. And you know, because the Bible says it clearly of those that their names will not be in that book of life. And that is what I read to you. Revelation 21, verse 8. But the fearful, can we say that after me? But the fearful, the unbelieving, the abominable, the murderers, the warmongers, the sorcerers, the idolaters, and all liars shall have their part in the lake which burneth with fire and brimstone, which is the second death. Death is escape from death. Death is escape unto salvation. Today, consider your relationship, the work of your hand, and will there be any of so listed in your life, you have the privilege to come to God this evening to get registered in that book of life, or to renew your registration in that book of life, or for grace to continue to maintain your membership in that book of life. Jesus is the way to live right, to get it right, to do it right, to have it right, make it right, and to end it right in eternity with him. Bow your heads as you talk to God. You know where you stand. You know where you are. Talk to God. If it is a day of registration for you, Lamb of God, I have come. If it is to renew your registration, just say, renew in me, O God, a new life. If you are there already, tell the Lord to sustain you.
Jesus' mighty name we pray. Guide us, O thou great Jehovah, pilgrim through this barren land. I am weak, but thou art mighty. Hold me with thy powerful hand. Bread of heaven, feed us till we want no more. The closing hymn, please rise. It's on the page 4 of the order of service. And we have it in the pamphlet, hymn number 9, page 4. hymn number 9, page 4, for those who do not have the order of service. The closing hymn. And you were with us, can see your mighty move. And we know that none of us will end up our journey in hellfire. Your word will not stand against us, but it will justify us for eternity. Lord, we ask at this point in time that we work out our salvation with fear and trembling. And we make the word of God our food on a daily basis. So that the enemy will not harvest our life. But we have a place with our Father, Jesus Christ, in his eternity, in Jesus' name. Lord, for Mama Eileen Adewale, at this confused moment, you are the husband to the widow. Never allow our life to be distorted. Stand by her and encourage her. Rule over her inner thought. Continue to show forth unto her that she's not alone, that you are with her. In the name of Jesus. For the children, the demise of your father will not bring setback to your destiny. Amen. By the grace of God, the father to the fatherless will always be there for you. Amen. Your mouth shall be filled with laughter. Amen. Lord, as we have done the service of song, journey to Ibadan, you will make it accident free. As many that will journey with them, that will travel with them, you will protect. No kidnapping on the way. Amen. no misfortune on the way. They will journey in peace. And they will return back in peace. Lord, we cannot but to commit Christian friends unto God's hand. The Lord God will continue to take care of you all. None of you will die before your time. All that have joined are to mourn and to have this service of song, by the grace of God, peace shall be your portion. As you leave this place and be returning back home, by the grace of God, you will not be wounded. Journey home will be accident free. You will not regret coming here. We pray for the children, friends, colleagues, and associates that are here. By the grace of God, none of you will die young. The Lord will give you privilege to grow old. Older than your parents. Amen. And of course, none of you will miss eternity. Amen. Lord, once again, we commit AVMCC as a family. You will continue to abide with us. Amen. Reign and rule over this cathedral. Amen. Protect us from every assault of the enemies. Amen. And the name of the Lord be glorified. Amen. So to God's gracious mercy, care, guide, protection, provision, fulfillment of life, we commit each and every one here present. The Lord keep you and guide you. The Lord show forth his countenance upon your lives. Give you peace. Give you joy. Give you harmony. Give you testimony. Rule over the thought of your heart. Never allow the enemy to rule over your life. The blessing of God Almighty, Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you now and forever. Our Papa, the Diocesan, the Right Reverend Dr. James Olusola Odedeji, who he will have loved to be here by himself, but by the virtue of the national assignment, and he has sent his message to us and his prayer that the good Lord will abide with his family. They will never be alone, and the Lord will comfort the children. And they will continue to see the presence of the Lord in their lives on a daily basis. We want to appreciate Hebrew Reverend, the Reverend Olalekan Adeosun. Please, let's celebrate him. Let's celebrate him. God bless you, sir. God bless you for joining us in this service. We want to appreciate, on behalf of the Dean, the Christian Friends. That is the society of Papa Adewale when he was here.
Good evening. On behalf of my family, I extend a warm greeting and heartfelt appreciation to our fathers in the Lord, the clergy, the Christian Friend Society, all members of my mother's society, and every single person who has joined us both physically and via Zoom today. Thank you all for joining us in remembering and celebrating the life of my beloved father. Your present support and kind words have brought comfort to our hearts during this difficult time. May God bless each and every one of you abundantly as we continue to cherish the memories of my dad. Once again, thank you all for being with us today. We're so grateful.
Flowers cross the sea. Memories aren't what they used to be. Something in the breeze, high and low, always incomplete. Fire burns my back. They stare, I don't know how to react. Try smiling for them to see that I'm happy you were free. Happy you speak. spoke to me, saying, come down, let it be. The grains of sand will never be strong enough to make them leave. I hear you speak to me as you spoke to me, saying, come down, let it be. The grains of sand will never be strong enough to make them leave. Stone rise, curtain falls, I am sure that you've seen it all. Christ yearn for harmony, clouds they turn, hear you call for me. Fire burns my back, I'm ashamed I ever thought you were mine. Try smiling for them to see that I'm happy you were free. Speak to me as you spoke to me, saying,